The coming in of technology has significantly changed our lives. Less physical activity, more availability of resources, and no time to spare, we have become prey to some of the most extremely uncommon diseases which our grandparents never even heard of. Lifestyle diseases are currently the biggest killers in India. But worry no more, because I'm going to put your life into the most healing hands of the founder of a state-of-the-art clinic in the heart of Pune city. It is one of the few specialty proctology clinics in India, a recipient of the Dadasaheb Phalke Foundation Award for the contribution to health sector, the mastermind behind Healing Hands Clinic and spearheading its entire team is its founder surgeon, Dr. Ashwin Porwal. Please welcome him with a round of applause.
Thank you, friends. First of all, I am thankful to GDG for organizing this and inviting me to give this talk. I have some questions for the audience over here. Can anyone name a few lifestyle diseases? Great. Great. Super. Anyone from here? Let's play right and left. No one on this side? Good. So yes, you all know lifestyle diseases. Can you please tell me what is the biggest challenge that the mankind is going to face in next 20 years, 30 years, 50 years? So that's a lifestyle disease, good. Anything other than disease? The biggest challenge that we are going to face in next 50 years? Sorry? Climate change, right answer. You deserve a Mercedes car. So that's the whole thing. Lifestyle diseases revolve around climate change. As you all are aware, human mankind has a history of almost thousands of years. We have evolved over a period of time. But there's one thing, one single thing, which has actually revolutionized everything, and that is software engineers. You people have brought revolution on the earth. Everything has changed in a span of 50 years. Sudden change for betterment of the country, betterment of the world, and betterment of everyone. It has made life easier and safer. But going ahead, I also see it as a double-edged weapon, and maybe we are approaching towards the other end of the advantages that we are enjoying today. So we should actually take a pause and think that where should we head today? And that is the whole purpose of this talk. If we can actually prevent lifestyle diseases, I'm sure that we are contributing 30 to 40% towards climate change. Then why Google? So answer is here. Understanding and knowing the disease, making an informed decision. Basically, it's a roadmap. It's like a Google map, which will take you to the destination, but then you need to leave it in the hands of doctors to decide the right line of treatment. Obviously, you have all the choice to make the selection. Everything can be Googled, but one needs to know how and where to Google. That's the important. A lot of us, like on a daily basis, I come across many patients. I repeat, on a daily basis, I come across many patients who will come and say, "Doctor, I'm bleeding. I'm having bleeding per rectum. Can it be cancer?" It is not the person which, you know, the patient who doesn't think of cancer, but it is Google which takes them to cancer. So there are various symptoms, and obviously, when it comes to symptoms and possible diagnosis, people start thinking about cancer, because just like climate change, which is again directly related to cancer, cancer is becoming a big thing, and everyone is scared of this C word. But trust me, prevent lifestyle diseases, you can prevent climate change, and you can also prevent cancer. So that should be the focus, that should be the learning from today's talk. And that's why it is important that Google can give you a brief idea, but then you should not get panicked. You should leave it to symptoms, try to understand the right way of Googling the diseases. So these are the various lifestyle diseases which I'm going to pitch on. Obesity, hypertension, you have rightly mentioned. Constipation is root cause of various diseases. Like in ancient time, it was told ki constipation is root cause of various diseases, whether it is homeopathy, allopathy, Ayurveda. We all know that if you are good with your digestive system, other systems remain good. There is a lot of science nowadays which says that the biggest brain is not the brain that we have, but it is the digestive system, because it has more neurons than the brain. These are the important things, a take-home message for all of you. I think it is just in time, just before lunch, we should know all these things. Physical inactivity, sedentary lifestyle, increasing use of vehicles and lifts. Now, I have been here since 1 p.m. The organizers have been very kind to me. Sir, please sit, have tea, coffee, juice, and all those things. But I made a point that I didn't sit for a minute. I was just walking, walking all the time, and I got the opportunity to walk almost for 45 minutes, which keeps me physically active, and I was able to burn my calories. So sitting is more dangerous than smoking and alcohol. Software engineers, I understand you are under a lot of stress, constantly in front of the computer. I really salute you for that, because as a person, I can't sit in front of the computer for more than 20 minutes. I mean, I start getting headache. And that is the case with most of the people who are not software engineers. So obviously, it's a stressful condition. But what happens is, when there's any task, you need any help in the office, even if the person sitting to you is in the next desk, you'll be calling the person, you'll text the person. What I'll suggest is, instead of that, take a break, move to the office of the friend, and you know, just ask him, these are my queries. Keep moving in the office. With that, you will be physically active, and the moment you take a 1 minute or 2 minutes break away from the screen, it decreases the stress level significantly. And you don't have to go to gym and dedicate for 1 hour or 2 hours. I understand everyone has time constraint, but then you can actually make the best out of your lifestyle at the workplace. Try to move around. Don't sit at one place for more than 45 minutes or 1 hour. Take a 2 minutes, 3 minutes break. Drink more water. With that, I mean, when you drink more water, you'll be going to washroom more frequently. So that again become exercise for you all. Also, as a rule, I don't use staircase at my clinic. My clinic is on fourth floor. I stay on fifth floor. Even if I have to go on 11th floor, 12th floor, I personally don't use staircase. Come what may happen. The reason is not only for my health, but I want to contribute every passing day something towards the climate change. I don't want to use electricity. I want to decrease the burden on electricity, and that is the entire purpose of using staircase. So I will request all of you to make more and more use of your legs, move around. If your office is close to 1 kilometer, try to walk to your office, cycle to your office. It will keep you physically active, and we all need you. The nation needs you, because you software people, you have brought revolution in 50 years, and I think you are the people who can actually save the world from climate change versus anyone else. So we all need you in a better health. The reason I'm saying is this is because out of 10 patients which I see in a span of 20 minutes, almost 3 of them are software professionals. So the diseases, lifestyle diseases, are becoming more and more rampant in software engineers because of sedentary lifestyles. Fast food, I typically call it as 3 P's. So whenever a patient comes to me on my prescription, there will be less medications, but more lifestyle modifications advice. And this is my favorite statement. I ask them to prevent 3 P's. That is processed food, packaged food, and preserved food. Trust me, if all of us take an oath that we won't have these 3 P's, you are contributing 40 to 50% towards the climate change. Most of the plastic, most of the chemicals, they are basically required for processing, packaging, and preserving these foods, which are in terms carcinogenic. They lead to hypertension, they lead to obesity. Many of you sitting here, I see every one of you is lean and fit here. I believe you all stay the same way, but I see other people as well who have obesity at a young age, who have digestive disease, hypertension. I mean, they look fit, but they have hypertension. What is the reason for them to have hypertension when they are fit? These are the factors which are responsible. I have been giving lectures in various software companies. At times, I've attended various sessions, and I see that in the lunchtime, they usually give them biscuits, Coke, Pepsi. I have suggested them that don't give that, stop doing that, give them bananas or apple instead of that. It will save cost, and it will keep your employees in a better shape and good health. And overall burden on the climate will decrease. Smoking, in a very low dose, smoking is good for health, because tobacco has medicinal value, but it also has addiction value, so that is what makes you smoke more and more. Same is with alcohol. In a very low dose, it can be good for your heart, but high dose can lead to liver failure and pancreatitis. Now, stress. Everyone is under stress. I mean, it's like whether it is your boss or it's a new employee, whether it is a doctor, patient, everyone is under stress. There's no way that we can take the stress out. The best way to combat the stress, or the best way to fight stress, is 15 to 20 minutes of exercise. When I say exercise, it doesn't mean walking. It means excessive sweating. Any form in which your body will sweat a lot will help you in taking the stress out. So whether you play badminton for 10 minutes, 15 minutes, whether you run for 10, 15 minutes, that is more effective than walking or jogging for 1 hour. So it is excessive sweating, which is very important to take care of stress. Now, how to Google lifestyle diseases? I understand that we are going 30 to 40 minutes less, and I was given 30 minutes time. So I'll finish my talk in 27, 28 minutes to save on time. You will come across various options when you Google on obesity, but go to the most reliable website, the website which is government approved, the website which is from an institute, which is a training institute, that will usually take, now in this case, see, I'm taking you to Mayo Clinic. So in this case, you understand the symptoms, you understand what are the next steps, you understand what are the investigations which are required before you go to treatment or before you select your doctor. That is very important. Also, such websites will brief you on risk factors and preventive measures versus treatment options. And this way, you can educate yourself, you can educate your children, and that way you can educate the world. That's how it is. We are also in talk with government to promote lectures and lectures on lifestyle disease in the syllabus, say 7th standard and 10th standard, so that they can carry home the message and they can go to parents, they can ask them, they can talk them about lifestyle diseases. This way we can prevent lifestyle diseases. So this is the right way of understanding the disease or Googling the disease versus going to something which is flashy on Google. Try to avoid that because that may take to your wrong direction. Always go for causes before you have, like for example, if you have any symptoms, you should Google about causes of particular symptoms. For example, if you have overweight, you should go to causes of overweight. And then you can obviously correlate the causes with the symptoms. So this is the algorithm which I have designed for you all to understand when you have any disease, you can use this algorithm for any disease to understand how to go to the in the right way. So first you can put your keyword, then you can go for credible sources like approved website, a good website which is informative, which is scientific. Then you can compare it with other websites which are again scientific. You will be, I mean, for every disease, there will be 4 to 5 websites across the globe which are scientific. Many of the websites, like 99% of them, they are just cut, copy, paste. They copy the content from an approved scientific website and the content is pasted. So try to avoid such websites. For obesity, you can use BMI calculator. And obviously, reviews and ratings are very important. So like the way we use reviews and ratings before we travel, like booking.com, TripAdvisor, and you understand that when there are thousands of reviews and say when 900 people say yes, it is good, and you read those reviews, you understand the positives and negatives of a particular thing, and then you can judge your, you can judge the disease and judge the doctor and judge the hospital also based on the number of reviews. That is also very important, but then that should be in thousands, and it should be descriptive. Same is for diabetes. So obesity and diabetes, this is very important for all of you to understand. Because nowadays we see a lot of young age population with diabetes. Is it really the fat which is responsible? Yes, the fat is responsible, but then we Asian, we say that I'm not obese, I mean my father is also having the amount of fat. We all have fat on the abdomen, and it is the abdominal fat which is responsible for insulin resistance. Insulin, to act on our body, it needs muscles. But then muscles, when you have deficient on muscles and you have more of fat deposit, fat acts like a wall. So even if your body produces insulin, the fat is preventing action of insulin on the body, and that leads to diabetes. So melting the fat is important, and for that, again, excessive sweating, improve the basal metabolic rate. There are a lot of dietary fads going on. I really don't believe in much of them. There are a lot of multivitamins and all the other things. As a doctor, I really don't believe on that. I don't vouch for them. Trust me, if you walk on the street, if you see the labor who's working at your place in your office, any labor who is working on the streets, I mean, he will be having chutney, chapati, and all those things. They hardly have meal, but you will see they have good muscles. They will be in lean shape. They don't go in search of proteins. They don't go in search of vitamins, but they are still healthy and they live long. Physical activity is the key. Your body has a tremendous potentials to produce vitamins. It has tremendous potentials to burn the fat. And basal metabolic rate is something which drives the human body. We are capable of building 100 machines. But machines, we can afford, if there's a damage to machine, we can replace the machine. But human, as a human being, we are born with just one machine, and we should respect it. It is the machine which can't be repaired. Once damaged, you're going to suffer for long. So respect the body and make sure that you're physically active. Same way, atherosclerosis, someone told cholesterol, medical term says atherosclerosis. Blood vessels, they are like pipeline. And we all understand the importance of drainage system, especially with the kind of rains we are having these days. Half of you must be suffering from leakages, water clogging, and everything. Similarly, our body has a water channel wherein the blood flows smoothly to various parts of the organ. But if we don't eat food properly, there'll be clots which will be developing in the blood vessels. And at one point of time, they can lead to sudden choking of the blood supply, which can actually lead to heart attack, brain stroke, and various diseases. So we are. It is important for us to keep these blood channels clean, and for that, we should fight stress, we should do regular exercise, and we should make sure that we eat 70% of our hunger or our appetite. You should never eat full. And once you start controlling your diet, your body get used to it, and a time will come, maybe in a month's time, you'll understand that even if you want to eat two chapatis, your body will say, no, stop at one chapati, this is fine for you. So hypertension is basically a cause of clogging in the blood vessels, which leads to hypertension. Hypertension, cholesterol, all these things lead to heart diseases. So everything boils down to lifestyle disease. It was rightly said in the intro before I started my speech that we are seeing diseases which were not even seen during the ancient age, or you know, our grandfathers never suffered from some such conditions. People in old age, earlier, they used to die of either old age or they used to die of some kind of infection. But it was rare to see people dying because of diabetes or heart problems. But in the last 70 to 80 years, this trend has increased 100-fold. Now, Googling lifestyle diseases, as I told you earlier, one of the root cause of various lifestyle diseases is chronic constipation, which leads to gases, acidity, which leads to various conditions like prolapse, piles, fissures, which affect the quality of life significantly.
It's the extra effort after you have done your best that creates victory. Constipation. Someone, somewhere near you, is putting an extra effort to get their morning deeds done. In fact, 22% of Indian adults suffer from constipation at some point. But what does constipation mean? Let's find out. In the past 6 months, if your frequency of going to the bathroom is less than 3 times a week, you might be suffering from chronic constipation. If you're experiencing infrequent or incomplete bowel movements, or have to put a lot of strain to pass the stool, you might be constipated. It usually takes 12 to 24 hours for our food to get digested and exit our body. But sometimes, the food moves very slowly through the colon, resulting in overabsorption of water from it. This makes the stool hard, dry, and very difficult to pass, causing pain and discomfort. Normally, constipation resolves by itself without any treatment. But severe constipation can lead to conditions like rectal bleeding and prolapse. Types of chronic constipation: irritable bowel syndrome, 40 to 50%. Obstructed defecation syndrome, 45%. Slow transit, 1 to 2%. Others, 4 to 5%. As the slow transit constipation is rare, we will not get into its investigation and treatment. Let's understand IBS, irritable bowel syndrome. Symptoms: urge to pass stools after meals, a lot of gas, bloating, soft stool or mucus in stools, increased frequency of passing stools. Investigation: colonoscopy. Doctor uses a small, flexible tube to examine the entire length of the colon. Treatment: medication like laxatives. The doctors will develop an effective treatment plan upon learning your condition. Yoga. Yoga can help you shut down stress by calming the nervous system and, in the process, calm your irritated digestive system and restore normal motility of the gut. Colon hydrotherapy. The muscles of the bowel are exercised, resulting in the strengthening as well as cleansing. ODS, obstructed defecation syndrome. Symptoms: extensive straining while passing stools, hard stools, dependency on laxatives, use of enema needed, digitation to remove stools. Causes of ODS: rectocele or intussusception. In 60 to 70% cases, a pouch is formed where the feces get obstructed. Pelvic floor dysentery: in 30 to 40% cases, there is a paradoxical contraction of the muscles instead of relaxation. Investigation: dynamic defecography. Dynamic defecography is done to diagnose rectal pouch and intussusception. Anorectal manometry. Anorectal manometry is done to study contraction and relaxation of pelvic floor muscles so as to diagnose pelvic floor dysentery. Treatment: biofeedback therapy. This is done in case of pelvic floor dysentery. In this therapy, the patient is taught to relax the pelvic muscle to regain its natural functions. If there is a rectal pouch or intussusception, STARR surgery is performed, which stands for stapled transanal rectal resection.
It is a minimally invasive surgical technique known for its safety and efficacy.
STARR aims to correct the rectocele, resect internal prolapse, restore anatomy, and correct rectal volume and function. More than 90% of our patients had a satisfactory surgical results in terms of faster recovery and getting back to their routine and work from the very next day.
Now, if I ask a question that, what do you think, which is the first organ in dialysis system? From where the dialysis system start? Anyone? Anyone here? Anyone here? Great. So, mouth, I'm glad that you answered it right. Most of them forget that mouth is the most important digestive organ that we have. We have time for Google, we have time for WhatsApp, we have time for Facebook. But when it comes to lunch, dinner, Marathi madhe ek man hai ki pratyek ghas 32 vela chavun khalla pahije. You know, you should chew the food properly. But because of the lifestyle, because of the kind of, you know, we don't give importance to mouth and we try to gulp the food. We just have breakfast in 10 minutes, lunch in 10 minutes, and then we are done. Ideally, you should give 20 minutes for your meals, like minimum breakfast time, lunch time, and dinner time. That's why the company allots 1 hour break time, lunch time. So at least you should utilize 50% of it. Once you start chewing the food properly, excessive chewing leads to saliva formation inside the mouth, which plays an important chemistry with the hormones which are secreted by the dialysis system. Trust me, this is the biggest medicine which we all are born with. If any of you who is suffering from hypertension, diabetes, or any of the lifestyle diseases, and if you start chewing the food properly, you'll understand that automatically your sugars and hypertension will come under control by 30 to 40%. Because of the chemistry which is being played by excessive chewing. And that way, you'll be preventing lifestyle diseases like obesity and all. So it's a request to all of you to chew the food properly. Give dedicated time of 20 minutes, 30 minutes for your meals. That's very important. And when it comes to meal, the most important meal of the day is your breakfast. You should have at least 70 to 80% of your energy consumption in the morning as a first thing. After that, throughout the day, you may have just 10% for your lunch and 5% or 10% for your dinner. You may skip dinner also and you will be mentally fit. Your brain will work in a better way versus having late nights, dinners and all. Party once in a week for software engineers is fine, that's okay, but it should not be on a daily basis. It is difficult to read and understand for layman medical things, so that's why I think videos is something which is very significant, and that is why as a preventive measures, we keep on putting almost one or two informative videos every week, and the channels remain up to date with thousands of videos. So that is another right way of Googling your diseases, because it gives you more information in a very short duration and easy way versus reading something. And obviously that is where the world is moving towards. The significance of this slide was to create awareness. We all talk proudly about hypertension, diabetes, various other conditions. There are various foundations for various diseases like diabetes, right from AIDS to various diseases. But when it comes to one of the most commonest condition, people don't want to talk about it. And that is diseases of your bottom. And one person from the family will suffer from it. Extremely common in females during pregnancy and other conditions. So why not to talk about it? It is important for all of us to discuss the diseases so that you can prevent the diseases at right time. So that's why I think it is important to create awareness, and that is where we stand, we have actually designed the disease in grade-wise, grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, grade 4, in such a way that if someone suffers from the disease in grade 1 or grade 2, it can be treated with medications, live cell modification. So that is the importance of live cell modification. Almost all the live cell diseases, they can be prevented, and you can actually avoid surgery for such conditions. I have 8 minutes to go, but I'll finish my talk in next 4 minutes.
Does it feel like every chair you sit on is made of barbed wires? Does your car seat feel like a throne made of cactus? Have you been standing in all your office meetings lately? Perhaps it is not the chair. Perhaps it is your, but it is nothing to be ashamed of. Estimates suggest that at least one member in every family suffers or will suffer from hemorrhoids or piles at some point in time. Let's explore the condition for our better understanding. We all have blood vessels in the anal kiln. When these blood vessels get inflamed and swollen due to any reason, we call them hemorrhoids. Occasionally, they form lumps which are felt as soft swellings at the anal opening. Hemorrhoids can form due to various reasons, one of the most common being constipation. If you are suffering from constipation, you are more likely to suffer from hemorrhoids. This is because a constipated person tends to exert more pressure to have a bowel movement, thus putting stress on the delicate veins of the anal canal, causing their walls to weaken. Eventually, the vessel wall loses its elasticity and becomes dilated, swollen, and torturous. Other causes include sitting on toilets for too long, pregnancy, family history, obesity, and lifting heavy weights incorrectly. Symptoms: if you are experiencing painless bleeding while passing stools, itching around the anus, feeling a lump outside the anus, or extreme pain while sitting, it is time to consult a doctor. At Healing Hands Clinic, we have highly qualified proctologists coupled with state-of-the-art facilities to provide comprehensive treatment of curing piles. We follow a scientific, grade-wise treatment approach as conceived by our founder, Dr. Ashwin Porwal. In the earlier stage, or what we call grade 1, the patient can experience occasional painless bleeding and itching around the anus, but no mass is felt at the anal opening. Grade 1 hemorrhoids that do not resolve by themselves are treated by an ingenious technique called MCDPA, which was developed by Dr. Ashwin Porwal himself. It is a holistic approach intended to halt and reverse the early stage of disease without any surgical intervention. It incorporates herbal medicines, diet counseling, and pelvic floor physiotherapy. In grade 2, the hemorrhoids protrude from the anal opening during bowel movements but retract back on their own when the bowel movement is complete. The early stages of grade 2 are treated with MCDPA. Advanced grade 2 are treated with laser hemorrhoidoplasty. In grade 3, the hemorrhoidal mass comes out during a bowel movement and needs to be manually pushed back by the patient. Grade 3 is also treated with laser hemorrhoidoplasty. How does laser work in hemorrhoids? Through the natural anal opening, laser energy is applied using a special radially emitting fiber. The controlled emission of laser energy leads to vaporization, causing the hemorrhoidal mass to shrink. Advantages of laser: no cuts, no stitches, quick healing, minimal pain, and patient can resume work by third day. In grade 4 hemorrhoids, the mass remains outside the body and cannot be pushed back. In this last stage, treatment is done using a cutting-edge procedure called the MIPH, also known as stapler hemorrhoidopexy. The procedure takes around 25 to 30 minutes. We have successfully treated more than 20,000 patients suffering from piles. Healing Hands Clinic.
So, finally, I think the final interpretation: prevention is better than cure. And that is why we should avoid these three P's. And we should have a healthy lifestyle by having some kind of exercise so that our basal metabolic rate improves. And we all should give at least 10-15 minutes for exercise. If you can actually go in a prevention mode, you will be saving a lot in terms of the burden that we have towards plastic, towards preservatives, and to other things. And once the production of these things comes down, we all will be contributing to climate change, which is very important. We want our coming generation to breathe. We want our coming generation to have to see the nature. We want them not to suffer from water crisis. We want them to be free from various lifestyle diseases. So I think it is extremely important. And the responsibility comes on the shoulders of youngsters, software engineers, who can actually help the world in bringing a revolution towards such condition. So in short, it's all about human intelligence versus artificial intelligence. Time has come to apply HI over AI. Thank you.
May I request Namrata, GDG Pune and Women Techmakers Pune to present a token of appreciation to the speaker. Round of applause, please.
Thank you. Yeah, that's fine. Thank you.